the side getting really red, you know?
Yeah, yeah, you know.
But look, in the end of the day, you and Chris are still a good team, still a good 1-2 combo, and there's a lot of talks that I've been hearing for months and months and months that Chris and Andy are going to fight. I know they sparred when Andy was younger, and they're both Mexican-American, they're both great fighters, and I look forward to that fight.
No, absolutely. That has the makings of a very, very fun, crowd-pleasing fight, you know what I mean? We met Andy when he was like 17 years old, man. He showed up at our old gym to spar way back in like maybe 2007, 2008. Chris was like maybe 13, 15 and 0, somewhere around there. And Andy's father contacted me. I don't know how he got my number, but anyways, he contacted me. And he said he would like to have his son come down to spar. I said, yeah, come on down. And obviously, there wasn't social media at that time, so I had no clue who the kid was. I had no clue. And they show up, and I just see this, you know, fat kid, like this chubby kid, and he tells me, oh, you know, I'm Andy, you know, we called you about sparring. I looked at him like, you fight? You know, that was me, dead serious, so because he didn't look like a fighter, you know,
yeah.
And I said, do you fight? He goes, oh, yeah, you know, I'm from Imperial, I got a lot of amateur experience. I said, all right, cool, we'll put you in. So I kind of told Chris, I kind of just, you know, just work with the kid. And he's caught Chris with something. I'm like, oh, shit, this fucking kid is quick.
He can fight.
Know, Chris going, shit, I ain't going easy. I got to pick it up a little bit. It was funny because he was Andy Ruiz. If you don't know him, he is the ultimate, don't judge a book by its cover, man. He is the ultimate, you know, you cannot judge a book by its cover.
No, I like Andy. He has a good sense of humor. He's very genuine. Mm-hmm. And obviously a hell of a fighter. I mean, to beat Joshua, Joshua's a great fighter.
No, yeah, you know, after that time they sparred, we used him. He came for like a couple training camps when we were sparring. He would spar regularly. You know who would come with him?
Huh.
It wasn't even, he was a wild card, and Jose Benavidez Sr. would come with him on the days you needed him. Him, sometimes, and then even Latif Coyote.
Latif, that he's funny.
Mm-hmm.
And Jose Benavidez Sr. is a really good trainer.
Good trainer, man. He's done a hell of a job with his son, both of them.
You know, he's made Zlatetanin a WBC champ. His son a champ, Jose Benavidez Jr., and David a champ. It's not easy to make one champion, you know?
No, man, he's done a hell of a job with his son. He deserves a lot of credit, man. David Benavidez is probably my favorite fighter in boxing, man.
Okay, him and Canelo, break it down. Henry, David Benavidez, Canelo.
Oh, man. You know what? It's just hard for me to pick anybody against Canelo right now, but goddamn, I would love to see that fight.
That one would be a big one. And then, okay, last one I'm going to ask you. Caleb Plant, David Benavidez.
I'm going with Benavidez, though I would love to see that fight, Ellie, because of contrast and style. And then, you know, boxing, it always is great when you have guys in a grudge match where they hate each other. You know, some of it's generated for media and for the fight, but this one is not.
You know, how do you know? It's real beef. That's really true.
They can't stand each other. There's real animosity. Real bad blood, and I just think that would really add to the fight, the excitement of the fight, you know?
Those are the best fights. I hate when it's a fake beef and the camera's off and they laugh. Oh, did you like that? Was that good? Like, don't do that.
Right. No, genuine beef is great for the build-up and it's just the real animosity in there, you know?
Henry, you know what always gets me? When I see a fighter that's a real nice person and he's not a smack talker and he doesn't jaywalk and they try to turn him into a villain like he's a dangerous thug. I'm like, come on, don't do that.
Yeah.
Don't try to fool the people. This dude's like a really, like, you know, goody two-shoes. He's like a church choir guy.
Right.
But, Henry, I want you to tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram, where to follow you on Twitter.
All right. On Facebook, I'm under Henry Ramirez. On Twitter, I'm under H Ramirez Boxing. And on Instagram, Riverside Boxing.
All right. And what's next for you?
You know, Ellie, I have a prospect of mine, Richard Brewer. He's 7-8-0. He's fighting on the Thompson Show November 1st. I have a heavyweight, Oscar Torres, 7-0. He's fighting November 7th on the PBC show. That's on the Luis Ortiz card. I have Marcos Hernandez fighting James Kirkland. That's supposed to also be on the Danny Garcia and Spence card, but, you know, it might get moved. It might get moved, I was told today. So,
wow, haven't heard the name Kirkland in a minute.
That was a fight from March. Yeah. That was a fight in March that got, we were that first fight up that got canceled. Top Rank was doing a show in New York. We were in D.C., and we were that first fight that got canceled. We were in D.C. already, and they turned us around and got us home, like, literally the day after getting there.
Well, hopefully the fight happens. Kirkland's a big name, so why not?
Yeah, that's a fight. That's supposed to happen. Like I said, it was supposed to be December 5th on the Garcia and Spence card, but I was also told it could get moved. So right now, just waiting.
So there you have it, everyone. Henry Ramirez, make sure to follow him. Always entertaining on Twitter. He keeps it 100. He doesn't care about people's feelings. He tells it like it is. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Mighty Sec back. Reporting.